Well, looks interesting.
All right. What do you think about the outside?
It's looking a little rundown.
So these two trees?
Unfortunately, they kind of look like they're growing into the house.
Would be pretty expensive to get rid of.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Wow, this is a really small living space.
This has got to be the tiniest living room ever. So for sure, if we bought this house, we'd remove that. I mean, I'm guessing the kitchen's on the other side. Oh my gosh, this kitchen.
Based on the size of the family room, the kitchen's actually bigger than I thought it would be.
It's a full gut in here, full redesign. We're looking at like 5 or 10 grand.
Oh gosh, what happened in there?
I don't know, this is...
Oh.
This is gross.
It's tiny. This is the only size sink that could fit in here. It doesn't even have any counter space.
Well, if we bought this house, we would have to gut this bathroom. It would cost us about $5,000 to $7,000 to make it brand new. See, look, it's so odd. They redid all with all these nice, you know, vinyl windows.
Wow.
What is that?
The house?
No, this shed attached to the house.
Oh, how do we even get there?
This is weird.
Oh, here you go. There's no way that could be permitted.
No way.
Oh, wow. In here, they were actually using this as, it appears, a laundry room / family room.
You know, I just thought about something. The only place to put a laundry in this house is the garage. That's a lot of plumbing and trenching. You know what? This is a small house, but I actually think it could get expensive. There are too many contingencies with this house for us to figure out what it would cost to flip it. So we're having one of our project managers, Frank, meet us here to give us a better idea. All right.
Okay.
So what do you think the remodel is actually gonna run?
So we're looking about 35 to 40 for total rehab of the inside.
Does that include the odd addition?
No, that doesn't. There may be a little bit of additional cost there.
35 to 40,000 is absolutely doable. So the first thing we need to do is try to actually get the house. Our full price all cash offer was accepted. So with a budget of 40,000, we're ready to get started.
I think take down as many walls as we can, such as this. There's no point in this one. And then I would like to open this one up.
Because the house is so small, we have to open up these walls regardless of the cost. So what's the word here? I know this thing is horrendous, but...
So we did a permit search. This was never permitted. So we have to bring it up to code.
My personal preference is to get here, you have to walk through a bedroom. Unfortunately, I don't think it's necessary to have this.
Let's take it down.
Okay.
Would it be possible to do like a nice sliding glass door right here? So at least you have some view of the yard?
We could put a slider here.
How much would that run?
About $600 to $800.
Okay, I think that's worth it, because at least if we put a slider here,
right,
it gets at least a little bit of a view of the yard.
The laundry room was out here originally.
This was the laundry room. Does that mean there's laundry in the garage?
No.
This is a much bigger problem than it seems. You would think the garage would be a logical place for the laundry, but because it's detached, running plumbing, gas, and power could be thousands of dollars. The only other place is in the kitchen. So last time we were here, we saw this area, but we didn't see this.
This goes to the old hot water tank room.
Is there any way to put the laundry in here and access from inside?
Yes. You'll actually gain another 3.5 feet by moving this wall back in the kitchen.
Okay.
And then we could put a stackable unit right here in this corner, which wouldn't break up the cabinet flow.
And then we can do a tankless water heater and put it outside.
Yes.
Okay, and if we move this back, this would be open all the way up to here.
Yes.
So now when you walk in, you're literally walking into one huge square room, open for entertaining. It's gonna be perfect for young families.
You know, I don't love a washer dryer in the kitchen.
It's either there or in the bushes, so.
I guess there it is.
All right. So my big question is, the big thing is, what is it gonna cost us to remove the load-bearing wall, bump this wall out, the 3 feet, and add the washer dryer?
The wall here, we're gonna have to do a pad footer, one on each side. Then we're gonna have to put a beam across. You're looking at about $8,000 to $10,000.
Wow.
I guys are moving quick. The wall's down and this wall's pushed back and the cabinets are already in.
Yeah.
It's really good news.
And I know you hate laundry in the kitchen, but for this size house, it really works.
Yeah, I mean, there's nowhere else to put it.
Okay, so we have the cabinets in, they look awesome. We need to pick backsplash, countertops, and flooring.
I think we do an all white kitchen. We can do the white quartz that has a sparkle. And we can do, you know, white subway backsplash because it's not that expensive.
Okay, here's my thought. It's about 1,000 square foot house. We've done this in the past. What if we grinded the existing concrete, did an overlayment, and did the entire house, including the bathroom, all concrete floors, like a dark, shiny gray?
Isn't that really expensive?
What is it, $4 a foot?
About $6 a foot, and you're gonna add about 2 weeks to the project.
Ooh, okay, so that's twice as expensive as laminate. Here's my thought. For this neighborhood and this house, I think it's worth the money and the loss of time. It would just look awesome.
I agree. I think buyers in this neighborhood would appreciate that over just simple laminate. But I feel like there's something that we could do to the island to make it different. What if we went and found some like reclaimed wood, all different pieces that are different colors? Would be super unique.
Okay, so let's do this. Let's go shopping. If it's within budget, $300-$400, installed material, I think we can do it.
I like that idea. So, what do you want to list it for? There's a comp down the street for $625.
I think ours is substantially nicer. Mm-hmm. We can go $639.99 or we can go $649.99.
I think $639.99 is the perfect price.
Yeah, and if we're priced right, we could get more than one offer.
So it's definitely the cutest house on the street.
Yeah.
Doing the front of the house a little bit darker than the back just gives it some more dimension, and I think it makes it look bigger.
Look at this.
Oh my gosh, this is amazing.
Unreal.
It's weird because it's a small house, but it feels so open. You can totally fit a dining table, couch. The island is my favorite part. Oh my gosh, we could not have done a better job. It's crazy because we went with so many different styles. It's just so eclectic. It doesn't really have a style. The flooring and the lights make it kind of industrial, and then the island is kind of rustic, and then overall it feels modern.
And beachy. And this backsplash idea and the gray grout with the gray concrete floor is just amazing. Oh my gosh, look.
I feel like we took a pretty big risk here by doing this wood looking tile, but I think once you see the kitchen and you walk in here, it just makes sense. It goes together so perfectly.
Look at this landscaping. Oh my gosh, it's so fresh and kind of modern.
Oh my gosh.
Oh wow. Oh my god, it looks great.
Hi.
How are you?
How are you doing?
Thank you.
It's listed at 639.9, 1,034 square feet.
Take a look around and let us know what you think when you're all done.
Definitely. Thank you.
I'm Sally. I'm the one that made the offer before. These are my parents. My husband's away at work, so I decided to bring you
along. Bringing us along.
Hi.
Love for you to take a look around, and when you're all done, give us some feedback and let us know what you think.
Pictures look great. Counters look great. Everything is dialed in here.
Love the island.
That's so original to have the reclaimed wood like this too.
I guess what washer and dryer probably. That'll be really nice.
That'd be convenient.
Definitely the nicest house we've seen.
Yeah.
Oh wow, look, they have the wood in here too, like in the kitchen.
This is nice, a slider.
Wow.
This is sweet. You can have like an office, have the breeze come right in through. Nice size master bedroom. I love how they brought the concrete in here too.
So what do you think?
I think it's definitely probably the nicest house that we've seen so far in my price range. So.
Love what you guys do with the wood here, because the modern feel mixed with this rustic wood is just great. I love having the contrast and mixtures with it.
You like it better than you thought?
Definitely don't take any offers without calling me first.
If you decide you want to write a higher offer, give us a call and we'd be more than happy to take it off the market now.
That would be awesome.
You know what, overall went great. The good thing is we know for sure we have a buyer. She loved the house.
Well, hopefully we get more offers. How long are we gonna give it until we sell it to her?
I would say, what do you think, about a week?
Yeah, a week or two.